morning and as we begin our time together, I invite you to hear the word of the Lord coming from Psalm 148. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord from the heavens. Praise Him in the heights above. Praise Him, all His angels. Praise Him, all His heavenly hosts. Praise Him, sun and moon. Praise Him, all you shining stars. Praise Him, you highest heavens and you waters above the skies. Let them praise the name of the Lord, for at His command they were created, and He established them forever and ever. He issued a decree that will never pass away. Praise the Lord from the earth, you great sea creatures in all ocean depths. Lightning and hail, snow and clouds, stormy winds that do His bidding. You mountains and all hills, fruit trees and all cedars, wild animals and all cattle, small creatures and flying birds, kings of the earth and all nations, you princes and all rulers on earth, young men and women, old men and children. Let them praise the name of the Lord, for His name alone is exalted. His splendor is above the earth and the heavens. And He has raised up for His people a horn, the praise of all His faithful servants of Israel, the people close to His heart. Praise the Lord. As we enter into our time of worship this morning, as always, we encourage you to take a few moments to prepare for worship. Spend some time in prayer and meditation, and as best you can, set aside all of the things that you may have going on in life in order to be present in this place today. But not just physically present, mentally, emotionally, spiritually, open and ready to receive whatever it is that God has for us as individuals, but also us as a community of faith this morning. So we encourage you to take these next few moments to prepare for worship this day. Now we will have our opening volunteer.
Thank you. Isaiah chapter 11, verses 1 through 10. And it says, a shoot shall come out of the stump of Jesse, and a branch shall grow out of his roots. The Spirit of the Lord shall rest on him, the Spirit of wisdom and understanding, the Spirit of counsel and might, the Spirit of knowledge and the fear of the Lord. His delight shall be in the fear of the Lord. He shall not judge by what his eyes see, or decide by what his ears hear, but with righteousness he shall judge the poor, and decide with equity for the meek of the earth. He shall strike the earth with the rod of his mouth, and with the branch of his lips he shall kill the wicked. Righteousness shall be a belt around his waist, and faithfulness the belt around his loins. The wolf shall lie with the lamb, the leopard shall lie with the kid, the calf and the lion and the fatling together, for the little child shall lead them. The cow and the bear shall graze, their young shall lie down together, and the lion shall eat straw like the ox. The nursing child shall play over the hole of the asp, and the weaned child shall put his hand at the adder's den. They will not hurt or destroy on all my holy mountain, for the earth will be full of the knowledge of the Lord as the waters cover the sea. On that day, the root of Jesse shall stand as a signal to the peoples. The nations shall inquire of him, and his dwelling shall be glorious.
Christmas is intended to be a transforming event, not only a lovely interval of business as usual. What we do in Advent as preparation for Christmas will be our means of getting ready for a new way of looking at life, a new way of living. The prophet Isaiah speaks of a Messiah on whom the Spirit of the Lord rests, one who does not judge by what his eyes see or ears hear, one who stands as a signal to the peoples that God is doing something new in the world. How do we prepare to be transformed by the coming of the Lord? By allowing the light of hope to awaken our spirits, by making room for sacrifice and confession to the Lord to speak something new to our hearts, by living in gratitude for what we receive. If by God's grace we prepare ourselves by renewing our covenant with God, then we will be truly transformed as Christ comes again into our lives. We light the first candle to symbolize how the light of hope awakens our spirits. We light a second candle to bring light to every darkness and to guide us in the way.
Thank you.
than just a legend, this is an account of how God, over 2,000 years ago, invaded the earth at just the right time in just the right place. This is the saga of a people crying out for a Messiah, a Redeemer. This is Israel's story. This is our story. Only an all-knowing God can clearly see our desperate need. Only a compassionate God could provide an answer. And only a loving God could send His Son, a Savior. The neglected and the esteemed, the poor and the wealthy, all to marvel at this incredible sight. They came to behold the mystery of the incarnate God now alive. And just like them, we joined their proclamation. Noel, born is the King.
Not with a royal procession in the bustling cacophony of Jerusalem,
quiet and barely noticed in the tiny village of Bethlehem.
Thank you.
praise you and thank you for the many gifts and blessings that you have shared with us. And we ask now, Lord, that you would receive this offering as us giving back to you what you have blessed us with. And may through the power of your Holy Spirit, you show us how to use this offering to do a ministry and a work that furthers your kingdom here on earth. Lord, we ask and pray all of this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Thank you.
You may be seated. the weak and powerless, he is a mighty God. To the orphan and all alone in the world, he is an everlasting Father. And to those at war with their surroundings or with themselves, he is a Prince of Peace.
Thank you.
everyone, for coming to worship with us today. We hope that this has been a grace-filled Holy Spirit movement to lead you into preparing for the Christmas season. But I'll leave you with this benediction. May the Lord bless you and keep you, and may the Lord make His face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. Until we come together again, it's in Jesus' name that I pray. Amen.
Thank you.